It's Monday, March 18th here in Seoul. I'm Oh Jin-ju, and you're watching Korea Now. Begin with the sex scandal that's rocking South Korea's music world. It's spreading to other parts of the multi-billion dollar entertainment industry. And with new revelations suggesting collusive ties between the police and former Big Bang member Seungmi's Burning Sun Club, it seems we might be looking at a more high-profile case. Police are looking into allegations that two members of the popular variety show Two Days and One Night gambled while playing golf overseas. The allegations emerged as police examined a group chat room of the show's cast members as part of the ongoing investigation into Chung Jun-young's alleged circulation of sex videos on mobile chat rooms. Actor Cha Tae-yeon is accused of betting thousands of dollars on golf rounds he played with fellow comedian Kim Jun-ho. They have both denied allegations over gambling, but issued an apology and offered to suspend their show business careers. Even before the revelation, the production team of Two Days and One Night had announced the show will be put off air indefinitely, taking responsibility for Chung's case. As for Chung, he has been questioned for the second time on Sunday. The police plans to request an arrest warrant for the disgraced singer-songwriter as early as today. In the meantime, a former police officer has been arrested and an incumbent police officer booked for their alleged involvement in the snowballing sex and corruption scandal centering Seungmi and his nightclub in Gangnam. Gangnam Police Station is accused of allegedly getting Burning Sun off the hook in a probe into suspicions that an underage patron was allowed into the club and drank alcohol late July last year. And it is alleged that Burning Sun bribed the former police officer surnamed Kang to act as a fixer to close the case early, which actually did happen on the basis of insufficient evidence. Amid concerns that North Korea may break off denuclearization talks with the U.S. and resume weapons testing, a senior official at South Korea's presidential office says Washington and Pyongyang have made too much progress over the past year to return to the past. The official added that both sides have expressed an intention to keep talks going. The memorial portraits of the hundreds of victims who died on the ill-fated Seoul ferry in 2014 were relocated from a protest site in central Seoul on Sunday. A special memorial exhibition for the ferry victims will be set up on a vacated area of the Gwanghwamun Plaza. And those were the top headlines for today. You can check the full-length articles on our official website. And don't forget to subscribe to Korea Now for your daily news feed.